Saif Ali Khan was very funny. He said to me that, you know, I meet you and we do this great interview and we laugh so much, and 1 week later I'm like, man, I thought she liked me.
Yeah, exactly.
Vinod and I are both sort of fairly reclusive private people, and we don't, and I think it's important to keep whatever, you should ideally have complete church and state separation between the film industry and yourself. I can't. I'm married into the mob. Just the sheer physical labor of making a movie is huge, and I'm not sure that most people see that. They see the glamour, they see the beauty, they see the, you know, foreign locations, and they think,
okay, hi everyone. I'm here with the renowned film critic and everyone's favorite film companion, Anupama Chopra. Anupama ji, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yeah. So let's jump right into the interview. First of all, you had once asked in 2011 that when would Bollywood status as comic relief at international film festivals change, saying that actresses with reality-defying statistics and minimal clothes strutted up and down the porn corridor. Do you think things have changed from then now, 4 years later?
Oh, very much, very much. The fact that this year we had two films in official selection, in a certain regard, which is, you know, one of the sections in Cannes, that's never happened before. In the history of the festival, we've never had two films there. So the fact that we had two movies there tells you everything you need to know about how the status of India at Cannes has evolved. And couldn't be happier. I think it's wonderful.
Okay, fair enough. And what's your take on this, the recent episode, I think about 2 weeks back, when Mumbai Mirror changed its star rating for Tanu Vij Manu Returns? I think the critic had given 2.5 stars. And then the next day, they published a column saying that we are giving it 3.5 stars because of the user and the reader feedback. And now I don't think that same critic is there also.
No, I think he's left.
Yeah.
I mean, what choice did he have? For the institution or for the platform that you're writing for to say that your review does not reflect readers' views, then why have a critic? Then just
exactly.
Have the readers' views. And, you know, there's a wonderful critic at the LA Times named Kenneth Turin, who was not very admiring of the Titanic, James Cameron's film. And he had written a negative review of the Titanic, and Cameron was really upset and said that, you're clearly out of touch with what people like. And Kenneth Turin responded with, critics are not applause meters. We're not here to measure applause. And that, I think, is fundamentally what people need to understand, that we're not here to reflect either the reader's views or the box office. You're here to give your personal informed take on a movie. Whether it agrees or disagrees is a different thing. So I think it's a terrible precedent that has been set with this.
Exactly. And I think the value of a film critic really goes down when
Absolutely.
Things like this happen.
Absolutely. And I don't know what value we have in any case. So, jitni thodi thi, wo bhi ab khatam ho gayi.
I think that's very well said, actually. Yeah, very well said. It's something which is not really talked about. But yeah, you know, when the critics get together and discuss, yeah, okay, we're reviewing the movie. But really, I mean.
Yeah, I often ask myself, and especially today, because everybody, of course, has an opinion on movies. It's the most democratic of arts, you know. I mean, like classical music, I would never dare to express an opinion on classical music. I just don't know it.
Mm.
But everyone has an opinion on the movies, as they should.
Mm.
And now everybody has a platform to express that opinion.
Yeah, yeah.
So what is the value of a film critic? You know, what am I bringing to the table? So these are sort of existential, angsty questions that we have anyway. And
right.
Then when you say that if you don't reflect the viewers' responses, then we just, you know, change what you're saying. Then there's no value at all. Because if you don't have integrity, then you don't have anything.
Right. Moving on, earlier this year you had written this article, 50 Shades of Grey, okay, and a lovely article, and I quote you, as a film critic I have often rallied against their movies, but as a Bollywood lover I cannot imagine my cinema without them. You of course were talking here about the three Khans of Bollywood. Now along the same lines, how do you keep the balance between a Bollywood lover and a Bollywood film critic?
You know, actually, there isn't a difference. I was just making a point here that I have been extremely critical of their films, especially Salman's films, also Shah Rukh's last two films, which I wasn't a big fan of at all.
Okay.
And yet, if you say to me that, can you imagine Hindi cinema without the three of them, I would be like, no, because I enjoy them and I have enjoyed watching them for 20 years now. But in reality, there is no difference. I'm the same person. I mean, I love Bollywood. I go to every single film with great affection and great hope. You know, I never go in with a condescending air of this is below me, or
I'm somehow
more intelligent than this. Never, never. I'm a Bollywood lover first and foremost.
Mm.
So no, there is no difference.
Okay. And you had also mentioned that tehzeeb is something which is missing from Bollywood nowadays. Could you elaborate on that?
Well, actually, that column was inspired by Javed Saab. Javed Akhtar was talking at the Jaipur Lit Fest.
Mm.
And he said, I think that, maaf kijega, but tehzeeb thodi kam ho gayi hai. You know, and that struck me because I think some of the conversations around cinema have become extremely shrill. And though I was talking about a few years ago, so I'm not sure if it's still true, because now what I see is an amazing sort of camaraderie and an amazing sense of being part of the same industry, and you know, people actually pitching in to help each other and promoting each other without rancor and without sort of. But back then, I think it was a bit shrill, you know, the conversation had become kind of a little crass, and that's what I felt, that wo tehzeeb thodi kam ho gayi, Javed saab ne bilkul theek kaha tha.
In the sense, it had become crass.
You know, crass in the sense that I remember some season of Coffee with Karan where, you know, people were commenting about each other's looks and weight and fashion sense, and it just struck me as being a little ungraceful. You know, that there's a certain professional grace that people should extend to each other. And I think that for a while, though, of course, Karan's show is great fun, and I watch it as just like everybody else.
Yeah.
And it is designed to be fun and to poke fun and all the rest of it. But I thought some parts of it sometimes cross the line. You know, that's what I was commenting on.
Okay. Fair enough. Of course, you interview all the major actors and directors. But when you criticize their movies later on, okay, let's say you interview a set of actors like a week before the release, okay, and then later on, supposing you don't like the film or a certain actor's performance, when you criticize that, so does that, like, you know, hamper the relationship you share with the star or the director?
It is awkward. Of course it is awkward. And Saif Ali Khan was very funny. He said to me that, you know, I meet you and we do this great interview and we laugh so much, and 1 week later I'm like, man, I thought she liked me.
Yeah, exactly.
So yes, I listen, I have huge respect, I have great affection for all of them. You know, I have been a reporter now for 20 years. We've grown up together. You know, I've been interviewing Shah Rukh since, I don't even know, like 17, 18 years. But does that stop me from saying that I didn't enjoy Happy New Year? No, it cannot. I think if I cannot speak my truth plainly and without sort of letting these things factor in, then I shouldn't be doing this. I think it's very important to have integrity, as I said before, because if you don't, then what else do you bring to the table?
Exactly.
You know, and the great thing is that while we while I share a really comfortable professional relationship with most people in the business, we're not friends. We don't socialize. I think that would be very tricky.
Okay, don't socialize.
Not at all.
Okay.
Not at all. So I think that would make it very complicated. You know, if we were in each other's houses having dinner and lunches.
But do you feel that the people who watch you on YouTube or not on your different shows and all, that they feel that, oh, you know, she's interviewing all the stars and she does it so often. So probably they're also together for parties and dinner.
I'm sure they do. That's a logical conclusion.
Yeah, exactly. And they share during those 5 or 6 minutes of the interview, you know, they're sharing such a good rapport. So, you know, they must be partying together on weekends or something like that.
No, first of all, I don't party.
Okay.
At all.
Okay.
Vinod and I are both sort of fairly reclusive private people, and we don't, and I think it's important to keep whatever, you should ideally have complete church and state separation between the film industry and yourself. I can't, I'm married into the mob, you know, so but at least there should be some separation, and I don't not socialize because I think it's professionally required. It is just who I am. So we don't have friends in the business, really speaking, and that is useful.
With your level of understanding of cinema, in the future, would you ever like to write or direct a film?
No, never.
But why?
Can't do it. Because I think it takes an enormous amount of courage, first of all, to be in showbiz in any way, to make, write, direct, you know, you create and you put yourself out there. And within a few hours on a Friday morning, people have either appreciated it or people like me have slammed it.
And
yes, and you know, and you have to be strong enough to take that blow, take that very public failure, a very public humiliation, and make the next one. That takes an enormous amount of courage, and frankly, I don't have it. It also takes an enormous amount of talent and hard work. I mean, just the sheer physical labor of making a movie is huge, and I'm not sure that most people see that. They see the glamour, they see the beauty, they see the, you know, foreign locations, and they think, yeah, must be having such a good
they
time.
They see the affairs which all the actors and actresses
absolutely
are having. Oh my God, I wish
absolutely
I was with her or with him.
Yeah, yeah. And I've seen many journalists asking actors, you know, achha, shooting ke baare mein kuch funny anecdote bataiye. But, you know, shooting is hard work. I'm not sure that there were many funny anecdotes, you know, or even if there were, it doesn't take away from the fact it's a huge amount of work. And I don't have either the talent or the courage.
Very, very frankly answered.
Absolutely.
And, yeah, it was a pleasure having you. Thanks a lot once again.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's almost like if someone is holding your tongue and you try to talk.
Mm-hmm. Try to talk with your tongue.
I get media people saying, you tell me one thing I can write about your personal life. You tell me.
That you can go on a date with any actor in Bollywood.
Okay.
Who will you choose?
Salman. Can you marry me? Aise kuch silly cheezein hoti hai. Someone writes, my mom wants to meet you. Aisa kuch hota hai. And that's very surprising, you know, me being a bikini girl and, you know, reading such comments, I mean,
right.
So.